Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. In this video, we are going to see love in the general for the sign of Scorpio for week ahead. So watch this video if you're a Scorpio, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, or if you're dealing with one. Keep in mind, these are general readings, so it may or may not resonate. If it do not resonate, do not try to deliberately fit in, check in any other placement. If you want to have a personal reading, link is in the description. If you want to follow my Instagram, where I keep on sharing information related to law of attraction and manifestation, I also have my manifestation course in which more than 800 students have enrolled and they've had some amazing breakthrough success stories. Everything is on my Instagram. You can go watch, have a look, and then you can decide to be a part of the tribe. Also, if you want to get your hands on my healing crystals, then I have a whole Instagram page where I sell my healing crystals. That's my online store, so something like this. So if you want to get your hands on it, you can just go and book yourself some amazing healing crystals. All right, so now let's see messages for Scorpio. And just when I cut the deck, this is your card. So some of you these days, I feel that you're analyzing a situation. So it's basically one foot in and one foot out. You're trying to see if something works for you or not. Some of you, you are in a situation where you are being judged. So maybe a lot of people around you are just trying to analyze you. Like maybe, you know, people are kind of observing you. All right, you might not be aware, but you are kind of under observation. So be careful to give your best foot forward. And yeah, when it comes to another situation like love or whatever, I see that you are not very sure about it. And you're right now, you are in this mindset where you are trying to analyze things and you're trying to see if it works for you or not. All right. So yeah, we'll see what that is. So give me the present energy for Scorpio, please. Hanged man, exactly. Some of you, you're just deciding onto something and right now you're just trying to take a decision as to what can you do. You're just trying to basically, you know, take a step back and analyzing. A lot of analyzing is going on. Analyzation is going on. Some of you also feel like your life has come to a standstill, so things are not moving and you're quite burdened by the situation, but you don't have to, because Hanged Man shows that in the present, definitely things can be stagnant, but what is coming for you is much better. And utilize this time to analyze the situation and make plans for the future rather than cribbing, all right? So that's that. Some of you also feel definitely there's like some lot of competition around you. So be careful that you fight back strong, because if you do, I see things are going to move forward in your favor, all right? Some of you also, you know, wasting a lot of time on internet, so you need to cut down on that and you need to maybe make a better routine for yourself. Okay, what else? What else for Scorpio? Four of Cups. There is some sort of regret on your mind. I see maybe you tried to make something work with a certain individual. Some of you, you approached somebody, maybe you offered somebody something, and this person denied, or maybe they did not pay attention and you are kind of deeply hurt because of that. For others of you, I feel that a situation is breaking your heart because it did not go the way you wanted it to. And now when you look back, it's very difficult for you. So emotionally, it's draining you. And secondly, I also feel that you think that you can't forgive somebody because of whatever they have done to you, all right? And it was some of you, they have ignored you, your efforts, and some of you, they might have backstabbed you or whatever. So you kind of, when you look at yourself, you feel like, I was the fool, why was I putting in the effort? So you're kind of self-blaming, all right? Something is just bothering you a lot. Like there is something, a rejection, or maybe somebody not putting in equal effort towards you, somebody not recognizing your effort is kind of bothering you a lot, which you're not able to let go of your mind is what I see. Okay, what else? Lover. Some of you were dealing with a Gemini and the High Priestess. What is this trying to say? You guys, this is like a funny thing. Some of you know that there is like a potential, all right, but somebody is acting very weird and it's kind of turning you off. Like, you know this person likes you, but because this person is not accepting the fact, it's turning you off. But it's like there is a connection, which is a mutual connection, you know. Six of Cups, you and this person share some sort of history as well. There's definitely love with the Lover's card, And with the high priestess, I see you had an intuition about it. That's why you approached them. But when you approached, they just behaved like there is nothing. And that's kind of turning you off. And it's kind of putting you in a very defensive mode. Some of you regret the fact that why did I even open up to this person? They did not appreciate it. A lot of confusion when it comes to your love life. It's like you made a decision, but then now you're trying to see if it was the best decision or should you have waited a little longer. Okay, what else is coming towards Scorpio? Chariot. Some of you, there's a Cancer coming towards you. Some of you, there's like a love triangle, so maybe you love someone and someone else loves you, or maybe there are two options. So you might not be aware, but there are options in love, and one of them persistently is going to try out to reach out to you. There is maybe a Cancer or somebody who's like very dominating in their personal life, and this person is also trying to be dominating in your life, and this person is going to approach you with a lot of enthusiasm, right? So some of you, there's like a lot of passion coming towards you. However, you are still regretting the fact as to why did I put an effort in the connection. So yeah, it's like a lot of confusion is going on. All right, somebody is interested in you. You were interested in them, but then it did not go as well the way you wanted, and now you want to pull back, but here somebody is showing up for you. So what's happening here? Six of Swords. Yeah. Some of you, Scorpio, you're trying to move away from the situation. You're trying to just isolate yourself from this for some time, and you're trying to look in a different direction with the Three of Wands and the Six of Swords. You don't want to open up to this situation anymore because you feel it's a waste of time. So I see that you're very, very determined that I'm going to cut this situation out and I'm going to move forward. See, this person is coming towards you and you are turning your back to them, is what I see. Somebody is very determined to make an action towards you now, but you are very determined to move away from this. Some of you might also be changing locations because you think that's the best thing that you can do for yourself right now. It's going to help you. But see, somebody is having you in their mind. Somebody wants to come back to you very quickly. It could be a Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. And maybe that was that. Some of you, this person was judging you, maybe. So they were not making an action towards you. You thought that they were trying to be mean, but this person was actually trying to judge you. So they were trying to see how genuine you are in your efforts and if they should be giving you a chance or not. So yeah. Somebody is going to text you very soon. And you also got a similar energy in Taurus reading, so some of you might be dealing with a Taurus. Somebody is coming in here with full force, and this person wants to rush in and tell you something. Love is finding you. Love is definitely finding you. But however, with the Knight of Swords, I also feel that the problem with this person is that they are very in and out. Like they are coming in with love, but see, here with the Chariot, it shows that they come in very quickly. And the Knight of Swords is also a card of speed, right? Somebody just comes in with a lot of speed and then they leave with a lot of speed. So that is something which makes you very conscious about them. Because this person is always in a hurry, you cannot really trust them more. So that's why you are not very open to this offer this time. You feel that this person is just wasting your time. So you feel that this person lacks balance and they need to be more stable before you can open up to them. All right. Okay, what else? Ten of Cups, Queen of Swords. You are looking for commitment. However, some of you feel this person needs to be more mature before you can accept them. You think that you are looking for marriage and this person is very cold. You're dealing with somebody who does not express themselves as much. They're very cold. Some of you, this person has an issue of repressed sexuality. So, they just try to be by themselves and they appear very, very cold and cold. And some of you, that's because this person has had some sort of trauma. So that's why, that trauma kind of resurfaces and that's why they behave the way they behave. And they are causing trauma to you now because you are having sleepless nights about this person. You are not quite able to make your decision about them because they don't give you the clarity. Two of Cups. But there is love here, It's like there is love, Queen of Pentacles. Some of you, it's definitely a Taurus or another Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. It's a mutual connection. Two people want each other, but this person is acting very immature. You need to find out why they do whatever they do, because some of you, I see this person has trauma, some sort of trauma, because of which they do not open up to you as much as you want them. And I see that it's not that you are close to love. I don't think you are close to love, but you definitely feel that this situation is keeping you in stagnation. So you kind of want things to move fast, all right? But you're not close to love. You just want somebody to make up their mind and tell you what it is. And if they're not interested, then tell you that even, all right? So that's your concern. However, I see you are not looking for you're not looking for a relationship, you're looking for marriage this time. So you want to date only if it has potential. If it does not have potential, you're not interested. So that's why you're being very picky, all right? You don't want to invest your time and energy in a situation which will lead you to nothing. So you've become very cautious. But the problem here is that whoever you're dealing with, this person is very closed off. Nine of Swords, Queen of Swords. Like, even if you try to step in and help this person, they are so traumatized because of their past, they are not even open to receive help. And if somebody's not open to receive help, how will you help them? Somebody is just very cautious, very suspicious. And this person in turn is making you very suspicious. Okay, what's the future energy for Scorpio? Page of Pentacles. I see communication is going to happen between both of you, Two of Wands. However, I see you will also have a love option in life. So some of you will have more than one option. And I see you are going to receive a communication from someone who went cold on you. However, by the time this person is back, you will also have another option. Some of you, maybe this person was not approaching you because there was a third party, so they had to clear that out before they could come to you. So that could be that. This person was full of red flags, okay? They were having some sort of trauma and they projected all their trauma on you. Three of Swords. See, there was a third party situation involved. What's the advice for Scorpio here? Temperance. Scorpio, your advice is to focus on your life. Don't try to go and save other people or change other people, right? If somebody does not want to change or somebody do not want to take help, you cannot help anybody. Don't try to save everybody. I see this person has disbalanced your life. You need to focus on your mental health and your healing. Because if you are not full, like you don't have your cup full, you cannot pour into other people's life. You're just trying to go and give to other people, but on the inside, you feel very, very emotionally drained. So if you are depleted, you can't help other people. Some of you really need to take care of your mental health and you need to balance your life. If something is burdening you, let it go. Seven of Swords, see? Some of you will also be required to make some sort of compromise when it comes to your money situation. Also, be very careful if you lend money to somebody because I see there might be a cheating involved. So, be very careful that you don't get scammed by someone for money, all right? Nine of Pentacles. However, I see your money is going to be good. So, I'm going to make good money, and maybe because you're making good money, people are trying to scam you for money. You know, people might try to borrow from you and then ghost you. Be very careful. I also see that these days you're looking really good, you're taking care of yourself, or you will, and that's why you're going to attract people. So, yeah, I see options in love. Like, you are trying to be happy by yourself or focusing on your money, but there are people who have their eye on you. And I see, yeah, see. Star card, you're shining like a star. Some of you, I feel that some of your wishes are going to be granted, and one of them is to have a relationship. Some of you, I definitely feel you will be juggling two options. Like, you will be having two options, and then you will be making your mind which direction you want to go. But yeah, I see two people want to have you in their life, and then you can decide. One of them could be a water sign, and the other could be an earth sign. Some of you, it's a Aquarius or an earth sign. Love is coming towards you, and more than one option. You just need to find the right one, all right, out of the two. Just make sure that you don't get yourself into toxicity again. Always remember why you walked away. If somebody is not changing their ways, there's no point of going back to them. And continue doing good, because I see you're doing good when it comes to money, your personal life, and that's why you're just attracting people. Continue doing good in your life, all right? Finance and career. Didn't I tell you this? Some of you, a lot of focus is on your money. your career, and I see you're going to do good, all right? And money is also coming in, but just be careful that you don't overspend or you don't lend it to people without doing the proper research, because I see some scam can happen. Getting to know each other, and we have past life relationship. Somebody from your past wants to come back because they want to give this relationship a second chance, and you might just sit and talk to each other better. Like in the past, maybe you never really spoke about your deepest, darkest secrets, but now you will, and that's going to unfold a lot of new chapters in your life in this relationship, and you might be tempted to give them a second chance. So see to that. Okay, I was blind to notice your efforts and feeling. This person is regretting why they did not appreciate your efforts in the past. Like, you know, we only recognize the worth of something when we don't have it or before we have it. So that's exactly this thing. Before this person had you, or after losing you, now they are realizing. I want to have twins with you. Some of you, this person might have told things like they want to have twins with you. I'm sorry. See, somebody's ready to apologize. You make me weak in the knees. You make this person weak in the knees. So yeah, I see somebody wants to apologize. Will you accept the apology? Let me know in the comments. So yeah, that was the reading. Hope this helps and resonates. If it does, make sure you subscribe, like, share, comment. I will see you very soon in the next video. You guys take care. Stay safe. Bye.